Okay, hey, this is another one of my after-the-fact videos. So don't be pissed off and write me all the stuff that you didn't show anything. Because this is basically the idea is to tell you what I did. All right? So here in a nutshell, this Easy Up shelter is not the cheapest one, and it's not a commercial one. It was probably around $500, so it was not cheap. It's fairly strong. But unfortunately, one of these arms broke. Which one? The one between the peak over here and the leg. All right, and this is 12 by 12, so it's pretty big. I went on the Easy Up website, and of course they don't make this particular model anymore, and they don't sell any replacement parts for it. I went on eBay, same thing, no replacement parts. I figured maybe I'd buy somebody who was parting it out, no such luck. So I actually fixed it myself, and it's been working since I fixed it, and I'll show you how. All right, so this particular leg right here, which is about 48 inches, snapped right at this bolt in half, in two pieces. Okay, so you had this, a piece here, and a piece there, two distinct pieces. I took it off, I unscrewed it up here, I unscrewed it down there, I unscrewed it in the middle, and I took the two pieces off. Then what I did, let me use this as an example. Pretend these two were the two pieces, okay? Then I went to Home Depot and I bought this, which is a mending plate, okay? It happens to fit inside of this, okay? So I wanted one that would fit inside of this. And then what I bought were two, wherever the screw is, I lost it. Anyway, I bought two screws with bolts that were about 3/4 of an inch that would go all the way through that from one side to the other. Jeez, I wish I had it. I'm always looking for those. Oh, here it is. All right. So here's what I got. All right. I got a package of these also. What I did was I put the two pieces together approximately how they were supposed to go. I lined them up. I put this on top. All right. I had two of them. I used two of them. I put this on top. I took a punch and I marked boom, 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 boom. I marked the four places to drill four holes, and I drilled four holes all the way through. So now you have two mending plates and four holes. I put these through to make sure they fit the outside. So I had 1, 2, 3, 4 with these now first on the outside. Then took them apart, mixed up a bunch of JB Weld. I put JB Weld inside of this up to about here, inside this up to about here. I put the mending plates inside, pushed it together, and then found where the screws were, would go, where the holes were. And I, 1, 2, put the screws through, 3, 4, and screwed them tight. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, but there's no hole in the middle because there's no hole in the middle here. And I needed the hole to be in the middle. I let it set. I put it completely flat and I let the JB Weld set up for 24 hours. Then I came back and I had one long piece that was solid with the plate, the two plates inside, and four screws sticking out. And you can see, I actually cut them off with a Dremel and a cutoff wheel. So I cut, here's the other side. I cut the heads off, 1, 2. I cut off the heads, 3, 4. And I cut off the other side with the tails. And then I drilled a hole. Of course I can't get the focus now. But I drilled a hole directly, let's see if I can get this to focus. I drilled a hole directly in, there we go. I drilled a hole directly in the middle where this bolt was gonna go. So now I had this solid piece with the hole, JB Weld from here to here, the metal plates inside. Now, I could have put the metal plate outside on this side, but I knew that on the other side, it needed to have a bunch of stuff go around it specifically and fit. So I couldn't put any kind of mounting plate over here. So I could have put one on the outside, I didn't realize that. But anyway, there were two mounting plates inside there with the bolts screwed through, with JB Weld, and I attached it back up, and I opened it up. We put the cover on, and it completely works. So that's it. It's a shame they don't make replacement parts. They should. I mean, you buy an 85 Corvette, you can get parts for it. You know, I mean, more specific, you buy a 2012 car and it breaks, you can get parts, even though they don't make the car anymore. Different model out now, you can get parts for it. The manufacturer makes parts. Easy Up decided they're not going to support their stuff. I would never buy another Easy Up product because these, I got two of them. There's the other one. These were expensive. And to take a $500 thing and throw it in the garbage because one leg broke is upsetting. That shouldn't be. They should sell repair kits, or they should sell extra parts. It's not that hard. They should make them all uniform sizes. They should sell extra parts. All right, that's it. Have a good one.